today is really the fruition of about 4 years' effort by a number of people. The combined force of UWA, its Oceans Institute, and the director of the centre here, Vibka, has come to fruition in the form of what I think is the only substantial wave energy generator in Australian waters at the moment.
What you see behind me is a wave energy converter. It is a device that transforms the kinetic energy in the wave into electricity. This is what we call the M4 Albany Wave Energy Project. This is a demonstrator that we are deploying here in Albany to demonstrate the potential of wave energy in Australia to decarbonize the Australian economy.
So M4 has always been a very exciting project because there's so many good things about it. It's the only Australian wave energy project through this scale, and it's the only project that makes data publicly available. It's been very, very exciting talking to the local community about it, to really empower them as part of this project, make them proud of what is happening here. The Great Southern generally is a very proud region. They always long to have sort of more clean energy solutions. And M4 gives them a tool for that.
So how does it work? You can see it, you know, it's actually two parts. We've got a back floater on my left ear and a front floater on my back. And so the device is actually flexing with the wave. It has exactly one wavelength. So when the back and the front floater are at the crest of the wave, the center is at the trough. And so that rotational movement is transformed into electricity through a generator that is placed at the inch. And so that electricity we actually capture and measure. And so from that, we can understand how much energy we can generate based on the wave resources that we've got here in Albany.
Albany has a couple of advantages. One is obviously it is the location of UWA's regional campus that makes obviously having headquarters natural, organic, and gives you that better social license to operate where you're already known to the community. Albany also has an internationally unparalleled wave resource.
So in a recent work that has been done by actually our group at the University of Western Australia, we have demonstrated that wave energy can be a fundamental enabler to other renewable energy resources, including wind and solar, because it does provide energy when wind and solar wouldn't. A big focus of our project was to demonstrate the capability of the local supply chain in undertaking a very complex ocean engineering project. So 80% in dollar value of the whole project has been undertaken locally in collaboration with SMC, our head contractors, and six other local contractors here in Albany.
So for me as an Albany local, it is very exciting. This project is once in a lifetime stuff. It's cutting edge research that you wouldn't normally get to do in a construction company. Nearly all of the resources and all of the subcontractors that were used to build this are local within a 10 kilometer radius of the site where we are now. And there's a lot of contractors that use the opportunity to upskill their employees. So for example, the welding that was done is from people that weld sheds normally who qualified against welding procedures. We went through the whole weld testing procedures with them to be at an oil and gas standard basically.
Albany used to be, like, decades ago and centuries ago, it used to be Australia's capital for energy through whaling and whale oil. Now the last whaling station to close in Australia, Albany ceased as that in the late 70s. And we're trying to pick up sort of that superlative Albany as Australia's energy capital with now being the site of a renewable energy, a clean innovation trial. It's effectively been 6.5 years in the making of bringing a wave energy project to Albany, to the regional campus of UWA. And today, as we hooked up the wave energy converter to the mooring buoy, the sea trial begins. And it will be an exciting 6 months of data collection.
It's fantastic to see the M4 device be deployed. It's an opportunity to really explore what is the potential to bring in a different mix of energy into the renewable energy mix that's critical for Australia's future.
The thing is, this is at the core of innovation in terms of wave energy. I think a lot of credit is due to the Oceans Institute and Vibka for their persistence in getting and deploying this particular piece of technology.